Hello, welcome to My Student Support System. In today's class, we will discuss about Spina Bifida. This lecture is in English, and if you want to study in Hindi, you can click on I button so that you can get link of the lecture in Hindi. And you can also visit my channel, My Student Support System. What is Spina Bifida? Spina Bifida is a congenital anomaly that occur when the spine and spinal cord is not developed properly. It is a neural tube defect. Neural tube is the structure in developing embryo that eventually become the baby's brain, spinal cord, and the tissue that encloses them. This is the spina bifida. This malfunction. Types of spina bifida. Spina bifida can be of three different types. These are spina bifida occulta, meningocele, and myelomeningocele. First, we will study about spina bifida occulta. Occulta means hidden. It is the mildest and most common type of spina bifida. Spina bifida occulta results in a small separation or gap in one or more of the bones of the vertebra. You can see here that the spine of this vertebra is absent. So there is a gap here. Normally, only a small depression or hairy patch is there in the spina bifida occulta. Second type is meningocele. It is moderate form of spina bifida where only meningeal membranes protrude from the defect as a sac and contains CSF. Here you can see spinal cord is there inside, but its coverings and the CSF comes out and it is covered by a membrane which is seen like a sac. And third type is myelomeningocele. Myelomeningocele is the most severe type of spina bifida. Here, the spinal cord is open along with several vertebrae in the lower middle back. The membranes and even spinal nerves push through this opening at birth, forming a sac on the baby's back, typically exposing the tissue as well as nerve. Causes of spina bifida. There are some risk factors in the spina bifida. That includes folate deficiency. This is the most important folic acid deficiency. Here, the folic acid or vitamin B9 is very important for development of healthy baby. And folate acid deficiency increase the risk of spina bifida and other neural tube defects. That's why pregnant ladies are given folic acid tablets in first trimester. And it is very important. Family history of neural tube defects, second risk factor. Couples who have had one child with neural tube defect have a slightly higher chance of having another baby with the same defect. In addition, a woman who was born with a neural tube defect has a greater chance of giving birth to a child with spina bifida. Some medications, for example, anti-seizure medications such as valproic acid, seems to cause neural tube defect when is taken during pregnancy. This might happen because they interfere with the body's ability to use folate and folic acid. Diagnostic investigations. For the diagnosis, we do physical examination. Just by observation, we can get some information. Ultrasonography, X-ray examination, blood investigations, and prenatal diagnosis is also possible by ultrasound. Sign and symptoms of spina bifida. With spina bifida occulta, The most obvious sign may be a tuft of hair or a birthmark at the site of defect. But in case of meningocele, there may be a thin layer of skin over sac. A sac is formed. Babies with this condition can have health problems if the nerve around the spine are also damaged. For example, if the nerve that control and release the bowel and bladder are affected, it may be very difficult for the child to control these body functions. And in case of myelomeningocele, there may be a thin layer of skin or membrane over the sac containing spinal nerves. A baby with this type of spina bifida usually have some paralysis, muscle and bone problems as a result of paralysis. This is due to abnormal development of nerves in the spine or the nerve being stretched or pressed as a result of this defect. Treatment. For the treatment of spina bifida, this treatment depends on its severity because spina bifida can involve many different body systems like nervous system, skeletal system. Children may need support from a team of medical professionals. This team may include neurosurgeons, urologist, orthopedic surgeon, physical and occupational therapist, and social worker. Babies with spina bifida occulta might not need any treatment unless their spinal cord is T3rd, means it is attached to the spine. T3ing can lead to problem later in life. So, it is necessary to surgically detach the spinal cord from the spinal surrounding tissue. After surgery, babies usually have no sign or no long-term health problem, but they may need surgery again later in childhood or in adult life if the spinal cord reattaches. Babies with meningocele need surgery to push the meninges back. What is meninges? These are covering of brain as well as spinal cord into the body and close the hole in vertebra or skull. This is usually done in the first few months of life. Babies with myelomeningocele need surgery in 1 or 2 days after birth to protect the exposed area and central nervous system and to prevent these areas from being infected. Nursing management. The baby should be handled carefully to prevent injury to the sac. The baby should be kept in prone position. A soft protective sterile covering is placed over the sac to protect it from the injury and prevent infection. Intake-output chart is maintained so that nutritional status and water balance is assessed. IV fluids may also be started to correct electrolyte and water imbalance as per doctor's order. Skin breakdown should be prevented by carefully changing the position of baby. We change the position. Mostly we keep the prone position, then we can change to lateral and then again prone position. Contamination of sac by baby's urine and stools must be prevented by proper positioning and frequent cleaning. Parents should be explained about the disorder and possible treatment to alleviate their anxiety. The baby's alignment of body should be maintained in every position, whether it is prone or lateral. After surgery, vital signs are monitored such as heart rate, respiratory rate, temperature is also recorded. Surgical site care is provided with aseptic technique to prevent infection and promote healing. Other nursing interventions include all the nursing care of a hospitalized child that we have discussed in previous lecture under heading Nursing Care of Hospitalized Child in the lecture Child Health Nursing. Thank you. You can visit my channel My Student Support System to get latest update and more such videos. You can like Facebook page. For making your notes, you can visit my blogger mynursingstudents.blogspot.com. You can follow me on Twitter, Instagram and join Facebook group Nursing Notes. Thank you. Have a nice day.